This year I decided to band Flexi-N at seeding. I purchased a retrofit banding kit from a producer here in WA, which is basically bolt on and plug in. With all the joys of seeding this year and I guess the initial nervousness of going to liquid banding, it really had no impact on time. It was really the smoothest transition into taking on, another process. And yeah, as a process panned out, it was probably the easiest part of my seeding program. The liquid banding saved me, on my operations, it saved me 2 passes on every paddock. So it's a huge labour and capital savings. We had quite a dry start to the season. There was a lot of dry seeding and a lot of staggered germination. Knowing that I'd banded the nitrogen, I knew it was there ready to go when the plant was at a growth stage to take it, as opposed to being top dressed on top, waiting for moisture. The advantage I can see of having it in the soil or in the root zone of the plant is that as soon as that plant has germinated and sends its roots down, it's going to access that nitrogen. I guess it's available a lot quicker and a lot more of it is available. So we've just kicked off harvest in the last week, and our continuously crop country that our soil testing has shown quite a low nitrogen reserves, there's been a huge response to the banding, and it looks like a huge response to yield as well. I think that if I hadn't have banded this year, that basically I would have been trying to play catch up with my crops. For most cereals, the yield potential is set up early on in the plant's growth stage, so it's, you know, crucial to have that nitrogen there as soon as that plant gets going, because that's what triggers your yield. Yeah, I think a lot of people are interested in the liquid banding at the moment because it is showing a lot of positive results. It's not hard to do. It doesn't have to be expensive to set up, and the benefits are huge.